My dad was just shy of being 19. And then he started teaching skiing immediately. You know, he used to go to the movies to learn English. He used to shadow the English-speaking ski instructor so he would know what to say. And then in 1943, he and some of the other locals who had come over from Austria, they made the sacrifice and they all joined the 10th Mountain Division together and went back and served in Italy and fought against the Germans. After the war, the 10th Mountain Division was dispatched to a little area called Heiligen Blut on the Yugoslavian border because Tito was trying to stir up trouble and take back some of the land that they lost after the first war. So where the 10th Mountain Division had taken so many casualties, and they were getting a lot of replacement soldiers that were infantry trained but not mountaineering trained. So they went to the high command and said, this would be a great place for an alpine school where it looks like we will probably be dispatched in the invasion of Japan. So they said, well, that's a great idea, but there is no mountaineering equipment. But the Germans, when they left Austria, had left behind a warehouse full of mountaineering equipment in this little town called Hall, which is right outside of Innsbruck. So they sent my father and two other soldiers in a Jeep with a trailer to go and, you know, recover as much mountaineering equipment as you can and come back here so we can set up an alpine school. So they did that, and my father said, well, you know, hell, we're only 70 miles from St. Anton. We should go to St. Anton. So they drove to St. Anton, and it was July 9th. My father always remembered that because that was his sister's birthday. And that happened to be the day that the French took over garrison duty in St. Anton. So there was a lot of French soldiers, a lot of activity there, but not a lot of Americans. So they kind of stood out a little bit. So they pulled up in their Jeep right in front of their house, and my dad got out of the Jeep, and he walks into the house, and the neighbor across the street is looking and saying, jeez, look at that arrogant American. He walks into that house as if he owns the place. So it happened to be dinner time. The house staff was sitting around in the kitchen and they were having dinner as these, you know, three American soldiers walk in. And the housemeister, who was a cousin of ours, was keeping track of the house while we were gone. And he stood up very slowly and looked at these three American soldiers and said, what is it that you want here? And at that moment, one of the chambermaids recognized my dad and said, Jesus, Mary and Joseph, that's Herbert. And within 20 minutes, the house was full. Everybody came. They had a big party at the Sporthaus Schneider. They broke out all the good wine that they'd been hiding from the Germans for 6 years. And they had a big party. And Dad said that was the only time in his entire life he was so drunk he had to be put to bed.